Hi, Anti Society. Welcome back to the Anti Social Planet, and today we are checking out episode 6 of Tomodachi Game. So, a lot of stuff happened in the last episode where we were coming to the end of this second game, and it looked like Shinho was going to be the first person to get to the end of the board, which would have meant that she was going on to the next game on her own. But at the very last second, Yuichi came in with some kind of plan to get Tenji to reveal himself as the traitor by getting him to be the only person who wrote down that he was the traitor on the piece of paper while everyone else's was blank, which was a huge, like, turn of events for me, because it meant that not only did Yuichi team up with one of the other friends in this game, but like all the rest of them. So I don't know at what point he exactly recruited all of them, especially Shibe. I'm trying to think of like when he was brought into the mix, but it looks like they've been working together for a while to go up against Tenji. So that brings into a question of like when that happened, how much of it was acting, and then how much of it was them legitimately playing the game. We saw that one of the, like, I don't know, mediator people who are like watching the monitors of this game, she said that it was since the second round, I think, you're able to see what Yuichi has been working on to get to this point. So Tenji has been revealed as the traitor. We've seen a little bit more of that darkness, that ominous energy that Yuichi has. So I'm hoping that we're going to get maybe a flashback where we get to see what Yuichi was planning. I'm assuming it had something to do with when Tenji was in the little booth to write down his card, because you had to be in there for 3 minutes. So that was like the only time I can think of where he wouldn't have been directly with the group, so Yuichi wouldn't have to like be very coy about what he was doing. He would just be able to speak to all of the others openly because Tenji wouldn't be with them. So I wonder if that has something to do with it, but I'm hoping that we'll get to actually see what built up to this point. And it looks like they're going to be moving on to whatever the next thing is. I'm really not sure, especially now that they know that Tenji is the person who started this game. So I don't know how things are gonna shift. I feel like we've entered like a new phase of the story, so I have a lot more questions than anything else, but I'm very excited to see how things start to shift now that everyone knows what Tenji did, and if we get to dig a little bit deeper into what exactly he's working towards. He said this was his chance for vengeance. I don't know exactly what that is connected to with Shinho. I'm assuming it's because they had some kind of romance before and it ended, so I don't know if that has something to do with it or if there's more to that story. So let's just get into episode 6 and see if we get any kind of answers. In 3, 2, 1, go. I also would like to know what he did. See, there was that too where it had the two of them speaking beforehand. Okay, so they've been working together since they met up in the classroom after the first game. Without speaking. Ooh. That's interesting. Did they leave them in the booth? Or did he bring it out with him? I wasn't paying attention of what order they went into the booth in, so it could be that he left it there for her. True. I guess he could have communicated with the other members too. That's so much more clever than I thought. To like pass the cards to each other. Oh, I forgot that we had that clip of them way back, and we never got like closure on what that was for. See, that's the problem with watching these like week to week. Even though I'm not the most consistent with watching series, I couldn't like watch a bunch of episodes and have it fresher in my brain. See, that's what I was. We had that moment, so I was like, I'm assuming that was the moment when they ended up working together. Oh, and that's why they were so close, so that she could read the note without anyone else seeing it. And that's why she said when she said, because it was to prove that it was something only she would know. See? I knew that it had to be important. The slap. It was too perfectly lined up. Yeah, the order's not supposed to matter, but it does. See, I noticed that too, that he asked Tenji to go first. See, I noticed some things. Ah, so Shibe wasn't really part of it for very long. Gotcha. Just plans within plans within plans. It's true. He didn't want to alienate him too much in a game where he could make things worse for you. So he has their name tags then. I didn't notice. That one I didn't notice. Wow.
Wow. Well done, though. Well, a lot of that one I didn't catch at any point. I wasn't paying enough attention to the name tags. The power too, though, to hold all of the name tags. True, he does seem to know about the power of money. But didn't he have like his dad or something who said that like money was the most important or something? It's true. He had them all on puppet strings, and they're still like happy with the outcome of what was going on. There is something very sinister to that. Because you have to hope that he's doing that with their best interests in mind. He was fairly melodramatic, wasn't he? He was very emotional. He's not as good of an actor as Yuichi is. Oh, poor Shibe. I mean, I guess that is in his favor in this instance. True. See, that was my thing too. I'm like, at what point did Shibe know? Because Shibe doesn't seem like the kind of person who could keep a secret very well. But then, like, distilling him down like that reminds me of how Tenji was like, Yuichi is dense, so he won't be able to figure it out. Sorry to break up your teenaging. It's true. There's a lot of teenaging happening. What happened? What did he say? You can't see his eyes again. Something about him? What happened? So he's going to continue alone then? So he has to have a penalty because he lied? What was in the seventh period? I'm trying to remember now. Why did he do it? I'm a little bit nervous about the idea of Yuichi playing these games without his friends there because I feel like they're a buffer of like him behaving in a certain way because he's trying to protect them. But if he doesn't have anything to lose and a lot to gain, I'm a little bit terrified of what that would mean for him. What have you done? Was it him? I'm sorry, people plural? Three? Okay, wait. Three makes him a serial killer. I would like us to get some kind of context for that one, please. I'm even more terrified now that he's going to be alone. Oh dear. I feel like they're all a little bit nervous now that run the game. They're just like, who did we let into this game? That's what I'm saying. Like, he doesn't have that incentive to behave in a guarded way, and he doesn't have people to protect while he's playing the game. I don't think that they are ready. I mean, accident? Oh dear. See? That's what I said. Three means serial killer. Which is terrifying if you think of it, that not only was that someone who's like in your class, but like someone you were friends with. It's true, though. I would like context before I have judgment. Also, Shiba, yeah, if anyone's gonna be judging someone for committing crimes, I feel like it shouldn't be Shiba because of who his dad is. He got them out of the game, though. I don't know if that's for his own sake or if he legitimately cares about them and wants them to be free of the game. See, it was like, is it because it's easier for him to leave them behind, or is it because he legitimately doesn't want them to be part of it? And even this, what he's saying now, is that also to further push them away to protect them? Or is it because he truly believes it? Would you rather be alone, though? Will being alone mean that he loses himself, though? Does he care, though? If he loses this version of himself, is that a detriment? Or would he prefer not to be this person anymore? See, but then internal monologue, he's like, this is how I protect them. Really? I'm sorry. Why did you call him dense? I don't know if that's the best way to compliment someone that you have feelings for. How can you prove it, though? I mean, you can show affection, but that doesn't equate feelings. Oh no. You can't just kiss someone. You gotta ask permission. I fandom lost its mind when this happened, though. It's weird, though. To have like this fixation on this girl who has a crush on him. But didn't they know each other before? When did Yuichi join the friend group? And is it true though? I don't know if I trust anything that comes out of Tenji's mouth. You know? I feel like I don't trust him at all. I always wait for a preview, but there never is one, so I'm gonna assume there isn't one.
So, I really need to go back to the part where apparently Yuichi is a serial killer of some kind. I mean, look, I want to suspend my disbelief for a little bit and say that there is some kind of more innocent explanation as to why he is directly involved in three other people's deaths. Okay? I just want to believe that it isn't because he is a malicious person. Because, like, deep down, he's trying to protect his friends. Because I was kind of on the fence. I'm like, is he doing this because he's trying to protect them or because of what he's outwardly saying of them getting in the way of him competing in this game and it'll just be easier for him if they're not around? But then we had the little moment of interior dialogue where we saw him with his mom and he said, this is the only way I know how to protect them. So I'm assuming that he does have some kind of connection with them and he does want to protect them. He does see them as friends and he is choosing to push them out of the game, push them away from him so that he can compete in this game and ultimately protect them from what the game might do to them and the friendship that they have. So I feel like there has to be some more layers to the story. Obviously, there has to be some more anyway as to like motivation and like who it is. It looks like it is possibly family? I don't know. I like honestly, I know that we had a clip of him talking to someone who I think was his dad, who said like money is the most important. And then in this one we had like the parallel of his mom saying friends are more important than money. So we have like these two opposing sides. So I'll have to go back and actually like see who it was in the first episode. I'm sure someone will comment about it. But one of the issues with having such a long time between episodes is that I honestly don't remember everything that's happened. But I'm assuming that there has to be some more layers to what that story is and why it's going on. And speaking of stories with more layers, I don't know if I believe Tenji, okay? I know that he's saying that the reason he wanted to go after Shiho was because he had feelings for Yuichi, but I don't buy it, okay? Maybe he didn't have any kind of romantic feelings towards her, even when they were like dating before, but I don't think it's because of Yuichi. For a few different reasons. Partly because he's said some like not nice things about Yuichi, like internal monologue stuff where he doesn't seem to have a very high opinion of Yuichi, but also Yutari also has a crush on Yuichi. So why hasn't he gone after her? Why isn't his like vendetta against her as well? It just seems like a weird thing. I'm like, maybe it's because he sees her as very timid, but also it looks like Yutari and Yuichi have like a closer bond between them. And even when it seemed like they were siding with each other, like in the game, he didn't seem upset by that. So I don't buy that he legitimately has feelings for Yuichi. I think he's using it as a way to manipulate his way into the game because he has some other reason for wanting to be here. So we'll have to wait and see how that turns out. It could also just be because I do not trust Tenji at all. I don't trust anything that he says. I feel like because we weren't getting a lot of his like internal monologue stuff in this episode, because the last couple of episodes, we had a lot of it from his perspective. Perspective, and this one we shifted back into Yuichi's perspective more. So I feel like there's probably lots more layers to what he was talking about. So I feel like both of them have a lot more going on with their stories, and it looks like we're going to get a chance to figure some of that out as they are the ones that are transitioning to the next game while the other friends are left behind. I don't know if they're gonna have to watch it and wait for the outcome, or if they're allowed to go now, or what's gonna happen with them, but it looks like it's just going to be Yuichi and Tenji who are competing along on this. I don't know if Tenji's motives are going to continue to be similar, like if it's because of the game itself, or if it is something that has to do with Yuichi now that he knows more about who he is. I don't really know what Tenchi is trying to get out of this game other than ripping their friendship apart, but now that that has shifted, like he has less of a chance of getting away with that, that maybe his motives have changed in a way, like maybe he is deciding to go from a different angle and achieve something else as opposed to like leaving empty-handed. So I really don't know what's gonna happen now. So much has changed about like how the game is going to work and how I see the characters as opposed to like 3 episodes ago. So I really don't know what's going to happen. Hopefully I was able to collect some of my thoughts in this one, and I don't know. I don't know what's gonna happen. I am very cautious as to what Yuichi is going to be like. I don't know if he's going to continue to be, he said, like having the safety on. I don't know if that's going to continue to happen, if he is close enough to Tenji for that to affect how he's going to behave in this game, or if he's going to show a little bit more of that darker side of who he is. And also, Tenji might show more of a darker side to him because he doesn't have as much of an audience. So I guess we'll have to wait and see. You can click this playlist to go and see my previous reactions, or you can subscribe so you don't miss next time I post a Tomodachi Game reaction, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!